This is one of the best houseplants out there. Forget to water it for a week or two, and it'll be fine. Not because it doesn't need water, but because as long as there's enough humidity around, it can grab water out of thin air. A power this plant has because of where it would live if it weren't on your windowsill. Since the forest floor can be a dark and sometimes crowded place, some plants have evolved to grow on prime, unused real estate, on other plants. But living far from the soil creates challenges, like how to get water. So plants on plants, which scientists call epiphytes, have evolved lots of ways to grab and store different types of moisture they do have access to, like falling rain, the streams that trickle down a tree's bark, even fog suspended in the air around them. Our favorite houseplant, for instance, is covered with microscopic hairs that trap airborne water vapor. Other plants on plants, like bromeliads, funnel water into specialized storage tanks. And epiphytic mosses have super flexible cell walls to help them suck up water around them. Some can absorb as much as 7,000% of their dry weight. For a comparison, a good kitchen sponge can only absorb a tiny fraction of that. Plants on plants' awesome water grabbing and storing abilities enable them to exist in all sorts of forests all over Earth. And in the process, epiphytes make more water available to the forests as a whole. See, water generally leaves forests via two pathways. By hitting already wet soil and running into local waterways, and eventually out to the ocean, or by going airborne, either after evaporating off of forest surfaces or getting basically breathed out as plants photosynthesize. Plants on plants limit both these kinds of water loss. First, because even though epiphytes only make up a small percentage of the vegetation in a forest, their water-grabbing abilities help them intercept as much as 15% of the rain that falls. So instead of hitting the ground and flowing out of a forest, water stays there, providing habitat and hydration for all sorts of life. Second, by hanging out on exposed trunks and branches, plants on plants can help shade forests and buffer them from wind, which means less water disappears into the sky. Epiphytes can reduce evaporation off a forest's surfaces by 20% and can reduce water loss through its leaves by as much as half. Plus, they can intercept some of the water that does go airborne and slurp it up themselves. By keeping water cycling through the forest, rather than leaving it, plants on plants can make it possible for super thirsty types of plants to grow and can help forests thrive even during dry spells. What's more, concentrated moisture can supercharge clouds above forests. In other words, plants on plants can help make it rain, which is weird for plants that can survive without getting watered in the first place. This video was made with the support of the National Science Foundation and a team of scientists at Cleveland State University, Franklin and Marshall College, and the University of Georgia. Their labs collaborate to study how interactions between storms and plants shape all sorts of processes, from nutrient cycles to water management to plant health to the climate. These storm-plant interactions are a big deal. They're estimated to save us humans tens of millions of dollars each year. And the information coming out of these labs is helping us not only understand how these interactions work, but also what might happen to them in a changing world.